Good morning. My name is Pam Smith. I'm the pastor here at Grace Evangelical Lutheran Church in Lakeland, Florida, and it is my pleasure to welcome you to this Sunday's worship service, to those of you who are here on site with us, and also to those of you who are joining us through the wonders of the internet. Welcome. Today is Palm Sunday. In our tradition, it's Palm Passion Sunday. We will hear the Passion account after we hear the processional account. This is the beginning of a holy, holy week for Christians and in the life of the church. So further to that, I would remind you of our Holy Week schedule. On Tuesday at 2 o'clock in the chapel, we will have the Stations of the Cross. Then on Thursday, not a mistake in spelling of Monday, Monday from the Latin mandate, a new commandment I give you. Monday, Thursday, we will have service at 7 o'clock here in the sanctuary. Good Friday services will be at noon and at 7 also here in the sanctuary. Those services are the same service. They're not different services. And then comes Easter Sunday, and we will have our festival worship at 10 o'clock. A warm welcome again to each of you who are visiting with us, as well as those of you who are part of this community of faith. One announcement for sure, not tomorrow, but a week from tomorrow, the office is closed, but Saints Alive are going to continue to meet in Fellowship Hall. And what time, June, Jane? 12? Okay, I didn't see you back there, June. 12 o'clock, thank you. With that then, let us prepare our hearts and minds for worship. Would you please stand and turn to face the baptismal font? Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 21st chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When they had come near Jerusalem and had reached Bethphage at the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them, "Go into the village ahead of you, and immediately you will find a donkey tied and a colt with her. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone says anything to you, just say this, 'The Lord needs them,' and he will send them immediately." This took place to fulfill what had been spoken through the prophet, saying, "Tell the daughter of Zion, 'Look, your king is coming to you, humble and mounted on a donkey and on a colt, the foal of a donkey.'" The disciples went and did as Jesus had directed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and put their cloaks on them, and he sat on them. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, and others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of him and that followed were shouting, "Hosanna to the Son of David! Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord! Hosanna in the highest!" When he entered Jerusalem, the whole city was in turmoil, saying, "Who is this?" The crowds were saying, "This is the prophet Jesus from Nazareth in Galilee." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. We praise you, O God, for redeeming the world through our Savior Jesus Christ. Today he entered the holy city in triumph, and was proclaimed Messiah and King by those who spread garments and branches along his way. Grant us grace to follow our Lord in the way of the cross so that, joined to his death and resurrection, we enter into life with you. Through the same Jesus Christ who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
Thank you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Everlasting God, in your endless love for the human race, you sent our Lord Jesus Christ to take on our nature and to suffer death on the cross. In your mercy, enable us to share in his obedience to your will and in the glorious victory of his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
The psalm this morning will be read by full verse with your response. Have mercy on me, O Lord, for I am in trouble. My eye is consumed with sorrow, and also my throat and my belly.
My mouth is wasted with grief, and my ears with sighing. My strength fails me because of affliction, and my bones are consumed.
I am the scorn of all my enemies, a disgrace to my neighbors, a dismay to my acquaintances. When they see me in the street, they avoid me. For I have heard the whispering of the crowd. Fear is all around. They put their heads together against me. They plot to take my life.
But as for me, I have trusted in you, O Lord. I have said, you are my God.
My times are in your hand. Rescue me from the hand of my enemies and from those who persecute me. Reading from Philippians. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not disregard equality with God as something to be exploited, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness. And being found in human form, he humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God also exalted him and gave him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Seated. The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Luke.
When the hour came, Jesus took his place at the table, and the apostles with him.
Jesus said to them,
I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I will not eat it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God.
Then Jesus took a cup, and after giving thanks, he said,
Take this and divide it among yourselves. For I tell you that from now on, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes.
Then Jesus took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to them.
This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me.
And Jesus did the same with the cup after supper.
This cup that is poured out for you is the new covenant of my blood. But see, the one who betrays me is with me, and his hand is on the table.
For the Son of Man is going as it has been determined, but woe to that one by whom he is betrayed.
Then they began to ask one another which one of them it could be who would do this.
A dispute also arose among them as to which one of them was to be regarded as the greatest.
But Jesus said to them,
The kings of the Gentiles lord it over them, and those in authority over them are called benefactors.
But not so with you. Rather, the greatest among you must become like the youngest, and the leader like one who serves.
Simon, Simon, listen. Satan has demanded to sift all of you like wheat. But I have prayed for you that your own faith may not fail, and you, when once you have turned back, strengthen your brothers.
And Peter said to Jesus, Lord, I am ready to go with you to prison and to death.
I tell you, Peter, the cock will not crow this day until you have denied me three times that you know me.
We sing.
Go to darkness, heavenly, all who feel the tempter's power. Your Redeemer's conflict see, watch with him one bitter hour. Turn not from his griefs away, learn from Jesus.
Came out and, as was his custom, went to the Mount of Olives, and the disciples followed him.
When Jesus reached the place, he said to them,
Pray that you may not come into the time of trial.
Then Jesus withdrew from them about a stone's throw, knelt down, and prayed.
Father, if you are willing, remove this cup from me. Yet not my will, but yours be done.
Then an angel from heaven appeared to him and gave him strength.
In his anguish, Jesus prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like great drops of blood falling down on the ground.
When Jesus got up from prayer, he came to the disciples and found them sleeping because of grief, and said to them,
Why are you sleeping? Get up and pray that you may not come into the time of trial.
While Jesus was still speaking, suddenly a crowd came, and the one called Judas, one of the 12, was leading them.
He approached Jesus to kiss him, but Jesus said to him,
Judas, is it with a kiss that you are betraying the Son of Man?
When those who were around him saw what was coming, they asked,
Lord, should we strike with the sword?
Then one of them struck the slave of the high priest and cut off his right ear. But Jesus said,
No more of this.
And Jesus touched his ear and healed him.
Then Jesus said to the chief priests, the officers of the temple police, and the elders who had come for him,
Have you come out with swords and clubs as if I were a bandit? When I was with you day after day in the temple, you did not lay hands on me.
But this is your hour and the power of darkness.
And led him away, bringing him into the high priest's house. But Peter was following at a distance.
When they had kindled a fire in the middle of the courtyard and sat down together, Peter sat among them.
Then a servant girl, seeing him in the firelight, stared at him and said, "This man also was with him."
But Peter denied it.
"Woman, I do not know him."
A little later, someone else, on seeing Peter, said, "You also are one of them."
"Man, I am not."
Then, about an hour later, still another kept insisting,
"Surely this man also was with him, for he is a Galilean."
"Man, I do not know what you are talking about."
At that moment, while he was still speaking, the cock crowed.
The Lord turned and looked at Peter.
Then Peter remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said to him, "Before the cock crows today, you will deny me 3 times.
And Peter went out and wept bitterly.
Jesus before Pilate, they began to accuse him, saying,
"We found this man perverting our nation, forbidding us to pay taxes to the emperor, and saying that he himself is the Messiah, a king."
Then Pilate asked Jesus, "Are you the king of the Jews?"
"You say so."
Then Pilate said to the chief priests and the crowds, "I find no basis for an accusation against this man."
But they were insistent and said,
"He stirs up the people by teaching throughout all Judea, from Galilee where he began, even to this place."
The chief priests and the scribes stood by, vehemently accusing Jesus.
Even Herod with his soldiers treated Jesus with contempt and mocked him.
Then Herod put an elegant robe on Jesus and sent him back to Pilate.
That same day, Herod and Pilate became friends with each other. Before this, they had been enemies.
Together the chief priests, the leaders, and the people, and said to them,
"You brought me this man as one who was perverting the people, and here I have examined him in your presence and have not found this man guilty of any of your charges against him."
"Neither has Herod, for he sent him back to us."
"Indeed, Jesus has done nothing to deserve death. I will therefore have him flogged and release him."
Then they all shouted out together,
Away with this fellow! Release Barabbas for us!"
This was a man who had been put in prison for an insurrection that had taken place in the city and for murder.
Pilate, wanting to release Jesus, addressed them again.
But they kept shouting,
Crucify him!
Said to them,
"Why, what evil has he done? I have found in him no grounds for the sentence of death.
I will therefore have him flogged and then release him."
But they kept urgently demanding with loud shouts that Jesus should be crucified, and their voices prevailed.
So Pilate gave his verdict that their demand should be granted.
He released the man they asked for, the one who had been put in prison for insurrection and murder.
And Pilate handed Jesus over as they wished.
Thank you.
As they led Jesus away, they seized a man, Simon of Cyrene, who was coming from the country, and they laid the cross on Simon
and made him carry it behind Jesus.
A great number of the people followed him, and among them were women who were beating their breasts and wailing for him.
But Jesus turned to them and said,
"Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me, but weep for yourselves and your children.
For the days are surely coming when they will say, 'Blessed are the barren, and the wombs that never bore, and the breasts that never nursed.'
Then they will begin to say to the mountains, 'Fall on us,' and to the hills, 'Cover us.'
For if they do this when the wood is green, what will happen when it is dry?"
Two others also, who were criminals, were led away to be put to death with Jesus.
When they came to a place that is called the Skull, they crucified Jesus there with the criminals, one on his right and one on his left.
Then Jesus said,
"Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing."
And they cast lots to divide his clothing.
And the people stood by watching, but the leaders scoffed at Jesus, saying,
He saved others. Let him save himself if he is the Messiah of God, his chosen one.
The soldiers also mocked Jesus, coming up and offering him sour wine and saying, "If you are the King of the Jews, save yourself."
There was also an inscription over him, "This is the King of the Jews."
One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us."
But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation?
And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds.
But this man has done nothing wrong."
Then the criminal said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom."
Jesus replied,
"Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise."
Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
Until 3 in the afternoon, while the sun's light failed.
Go ahead.
And the curtain of the temple was torn in two.
Then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said,
"Father, into your hands I commend my spirit."
Having said this, he breathed his last. When the centurion saw what had taken place, he praised God and said,
"Certainly this man was innocent."
And when all the crowds who had gathered there for this spectacle saw what had taken place, they returned home beating their breasts.
But all Jesus' acquaintances, including the women who had followed him from Galilee, stood at a distance watching these things.
The Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Sustained by God's mercy, abundant mercy, let us pray for the church, the world, and all creation. Save your church, O God. Enable us to boldly confess in every time and place that Jesus Christ is Lord. With the humility of a servant, equip congregations, synods, and other ministry settings to proclaim your extravagant love for us all. As we enter into the sacred time of Holy Week, sustain us and open our hearts to the depth of your love for the world. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Save your creation, O God. Every living being you have made has purpose. Give us renewed appreciation of farm animals who labor in the fields, service animals who accompany their human companions, and beloved pets who live alongside us. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Save the peoples of the earth, O God. Restore dignity to those who are scorned and persecuted for their religious beliefs or political activism, and deliver them from the hands of their enemies. Bring peace to places where conflicts run deep. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Save those who cry to you in any need, O God. Watch over all who are incarcerated and awaiting trial, and stand with those who are unjustly accused. Be present with those feeling isolated, lonely, fearful, and ill, particularly Arlene, Tim, Sherry, Mabel, Mike, Anna Mae, Julie, Carol G., Carol, Ann, Lydia, Paul, Will, Betty, Scott, Ron, Flo, Doris, Dottie, Teresa, Marion P., Ian, Tim, Julie, Ed, Henry, Mary, Greg, and Max. Merciful God,
receive our prayers.
Save us, God, from all that threatens, from fear, from weapons, and apathy. Again, in this time of national disaster, turn our hearts to you and grant us compassion and wisdom. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
Save us at the last, O God. We give you thanks for your saints of old who embodied your servant love. As you came to their aid, so deliver us in times of trial, that every knee may be bent in praise to you. Merciful God,
receive our prayer.
We lift our prayers to you, O God, trusting in your steadfast love and your promise to renew your whole creation. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
We share a sign of that peace with one another.
Let us pray. Extravagant God, you have blessed us with the fullness of creation. Now we gather at your feast where you offer us the food that satisfies us. Take and use what we offer here. Come among us and feed us with the body and blood of Christ, in whose name we pray. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and Merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, whose suffering and death gave salvation to all. You gather your people around the tree of the cross, transforming death into life. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Amen.
Blessed are you, O God of the universe. Your mercy is everlasting, and your faithfulness endures from age to age. Praise to you for creating the heavens and the earth. Praise to you for saving the earth from the waters of the flood. Praise to you for bringing the Israelites safely through the sea. Praise to you for leading your people through the wilderness to the land of milk and honey. Praise to you for the words and deeds of Jesus, your anointed one. Praise to you for the death and resurrection of Christ. Praise to you for your spirit poured out on all nations. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup. He gave thanks and he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." With this bread and cup, we remember our Lord's Passover from death to life as we proclaim the mystery of our faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. O God of resurrection and new life, pour out your Holy Spirit on us and on these gifts of bread and wine. Bless this feast. Grace our table with your presence. Come, Holy Spirit. Reveal yourself to us in the breaking of the bread. Raise us up as the body of Christ for the world. Breathe new life into us. Send us forth burning with justice, peace, and love. Come, Holy Spirit. With your holy ones of all times and places, with the earth and all its creatures, with sun and moon and stars, we praise you, O God. Blessed and holy Trinity, now and forever. Amen. We are bold to pray as our Savior taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. My friends, we commune at the altar rail. As you see an open spot, please come and kneel and you will be fed. The bread will be given to you. That will be followed by the chalices. The first chalice is for intinction. The second chalice is for drinking. And the third chalice is one of juice. Please come, all is now ready.
Thank you.
please stand. And now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ preserve us unto life everlasting. Amen.
Blessed Jesus, in this rich meal of grace, you have fed us with your body, the bread of life. Now send us forth to bear your life-giving hope to a world in need.
Amen. Amen. And now I would invite you to join with me in our sending hymn. My song is Love Unknown. It's number 343 in the hymnal if you would like to follow along with the music. And now I would invite you to move to the side aisles for our benediction and charge. And so, my friends, go out into the world in peace.
Go out into the world in peace.
Be of good courage.
Hold fast to that which is good.
Return no one evil for evil.
Strengthen the faint-hearted.
Support the weak.
Help the suffering.
Rejoice in beauty.
Speak love with word and deed.
Honor all people. And may the blessing of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be upon you now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
Go in peace. Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And one more word from your pastor. This is not original to me. Pastor shared it. Closing this way. May your holy week bring you closer to the one who got up Sunday morning. Isn't that good? Please, coffee is in Fellowship Hall.